Hi, good morning, one and all. So let us welcome to 8th biology online video class. So in this class today we are going to explain about the 5th chapter, that is called as attaining the age of adolescence. In the previous years, the textbook they are given to that reaching the age of adolescence. Reaching means attaining, or you are coming to that age. So that is called as attaining the age of adolescence. See, in 8th class biology, actually it is a very new subject. Of course, you have just now completed the 7th standard as you studied general science, means physical science, means that the physics and chemistry as well as the biology concepts together, you constitute a common book that is called as a general science. But all of a sudden, when you are promoted to 8th standard, we called separately two main divisions. One is physical science, means physical environment like air, water, friction, force, electricity, magnetism, sound. So all these are physical parameters which plays a vital role on the to support that life is exist in the nature. For example, without air, without food, without water, of course there is no life on that these non-biotic components, even though we cannot survive. So that first physical science is the first general science paper 1, as you learn that 9th and 10th standard. Next general science paper 2 is called as biological science. So first physical science paper 2 is biological science. So I would like to continue this biology. So till now we completed the 4 chapters. Out of these 4, we learn some of the new things which are related to very quite interesting in that nature. For example, see what is mean by science. There you learn about the science importance, the science definitions, and why science, and how the science plays a vital role in present situation. How the difference between the old man, that means previous to present modern man. So primitive man to present modern man, there is a lot of differences. So all the factors you discussed clearly in that what is science. Next lesson, cell, the basic unit of life. Of course, all the living organisms, they began their life from the single cell, that is called a zygote cell. That continuation we learn about in reproduction in animals. Like a zygote, you learn that it is a fusion of the male and female gametes, forms the zygote. Zygote develop into embryo, embryo leads to fetus, fetus leads to childbirth. So the first chapter, cell, the basic unit of life, there you learn that zygote cell is the basic cell which leads to the life. So apart from that, you learn about typical plant cell, animal cell, and the cell basic components, their cell organelles, outline sketch of the plant cell and animal cell. So all these concepts you learn that in that cell, the basic unit of life. Next chapter, story of microorganisms. It is a very vast chapter because of microbial world, it is a separate world which cannot be visible to naked eyes. So we are unable to see this world with our normal eye or naked eye. We need a particular tool that we call as a microscope. So it is called as a microbiology. There we learn about part 1, part 2 clearly about these stories of microorganisms, like 4 stories in the part 2 and 5 kinds of major groups of these microorganisms activity in part 1. So then we move to the 4th chapter, reproduction in animals. So in previous videos all we discussed it clearly, these reproduction in animals, how the organisms are reproduced. So basically the modes of reproduction are two kinds. One is asexual mode and sexual mode of reproduction, that we discussed clearly in that previous video. That somewhat closely related the sexual mode of reproduction, that was closely related to present our chapter reproduction in animals. The sexual mode of reproduction, that is somewhat related to our present topic, attaining the age of adolescence. Why? Because sexual reproduction means sexual organs starts development when we are reaching the some age, that means adolescence age or puberty age or maturity age. So that I would like to recall all the concepts till now what we discussed. It is very closely related one topic to another topic in biology concept. See, actually coming to that attaining, so while you are reaching the age of adolescence, actually now you are in 8th standard. Of course, approximately you are reaching to that 13 years. You are crossing the 11 to 12 years, and at present majority of the your class members are reaching to 13 years of age, because of according to the school age regarding to the statistical data. So now you are in a 8th standard. So most probably majority of the students, at least one or two members may be some excuse, remaining all the members they may be reached to that adolescence, I mean that 13 years age. So attaining the age of adolescence or reaching the age of adolescence. So in this lesson what we are going to learn, so what are the learning objectives, outcomes of this chapter, means first of all let me know about what is the term of adolescence. So what is meant by adolescence? What is the meaning? And what is the characteristics of the adolescence students? So adolescence persons, how they have to identify. So what are the characteristics of adolescence? Next, changes at adolescence. So what are the changes are undergoes in the adolescence persons? Next, changes in our body. So what are the changes we are going to notice? For example, tall. That means growing tall. And voice becomes to change, hoarse voice. So some of the characters we are going to observe in our body. Next, reproductive phase of life in the humans. As we said, reproductive phase. So after maturation, when we are coming to the matured stage, the reproductive organs, the sexual organs starts beginning to reproduce. Reproduction gets ready. Next, hormones. You know that hormones are nothing but the chemical substances. Hormone means it is a impel. It is a chemical messengers. Chemical messengers which makes a plays a vital role in balancing our sexual organs in our body. So hormones and adolescence. How the hormones plays? For example, testosterone hormone in males which produce the these sperms in the testes. As like in females, the ovaries, estrogen hormone plays a vital role to produce that hormones. And the ovums are released by that ovulation process, monthly once. So, all these phenomena is based on that hormone related. So, our internal body changes based on the hormones, and the external changes in our body based on that, these are the changes occurs in our body. So, let us coming to adolescence. We are having different names of these adolescence. Of course, we are calling this puberty age, means maturing age. So maturity years are also called as teenage or young age. So teenage means for example when we are coming to the 13, so ending teen, suffix is teen. So 13 to 19, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So this is the age of teenage or young age or adolescence age or puberty age or maturity age. So this is the age according to the adolescence. So actually according to WHO, the age between the 13 to 19 years age is called as adolescence age. That age changes occurs in both the external and the internal. For example, the external changes in our body like this growing in a tall. By coming to the internal changes in our body like changes in a voice. So this is the somewhat introduction part of this attaining the age of adolescence. So how to go to that this lesson, how to understand this lesson. So what is the importance of this lesson? So actually in our human beings we are having the different phases in our life cycle. For example, inborn babies, that means infant babies are growing in a fast manner. After they are reaching 2 to 3 years, again they have to stop that age in it frequently. So they have to once again slow down the growth age in the preschooling. So once again they have to cross in the childhood stage. I mean that once they are reaching the 11 to 12 years, once again they have to begin the rapid growth, abnormal growth we can observe. It seems to be observed in that 13 to 19 years. Why? Because this is the age of growing. This is the age of maturing. This is the age of puberty. This is the age of teenage. So how to identify? Yes, I am reaching to the adolescence age. What parameters and what basis we are considered that you are reaching to the adolescence? So there is a beautiful introduction part in that our textbook. Just we have to support the textbook and better to understand these concepts. See children, here this is a confusion state of adolescence. It is a confusion state. See here, there is a boy is standing in middle portion. Who am I? He is questioning himself. Why? Because if you are too old to play, because he is crossing the preschool age. That means he crossed that age of 11 to 12 years. So he is unable to play with the children like small kids. When compared to kids, it is a big. When compared to the youngsters, I mean that like intermediate children or junior intermediate or senior intermediate children, when compared to that, it is a small children. So you are not old enough to sit with us and go and play. So he is just a confusion state. Who am I? I am not a kid to play with the small children. I am not a adult to play with the adult person. I am in a confused state. So who am I? He is questioning himself. So the answer is adolescence. Why? Because he is in a growing age. He is reaching the adolescence age. So adolescence means, according to WHO, usually we see the changes in the age of adolescence means 13 to 19 years according to WHO. This is the period is called as adolescence. During this period, the changes are observed in inside and inside internal and outside external. For example, changes in voice in the internal, growing tall is the external. So let us coming to the introduction part of this chapter. See, actually Naveen is studying 8th class. One of the boy in our class, Naveen, is studying 8th class. He is very active. Actually, he is very active and he has been ideal these days. So he would like to become an ideal. For example, he would like to impress the teacher because he would like to ideal to the these days. He even feels shy while talking to the strangers and even with the relatives. For example, he is quite feeling shy while talking with the strangers and even with the relatives also visiting their home. So if he starts speaking, his voice becomes somewhat hoarse. Previously it is not a hoarse voice, a sweet voice. There is no difference between the boy and girl voice differences. But while they are reaching the adolescence, the boy's voice becomes too hoarse. This we will explain in a detailed manner. Next, he does not care to follow the suggestions of their parents, advice of his parents. He shows the restlessness. He is not having enough patience. If parents tell him to put his books in the bag or bring something from the market, he does not have to care the parents' suggestions or parent words. So his parents are worried on his noticing his changing behavior. Previously, he was very impressive to that parents' suggestions, but nowadays his behavior is changing according to the age factor. So his parents are worried on his noticing his changing behavior. Naveen's grandmother says he is growing now. So Naveen's grandmother says that he is growing now. So that is why he is not listening to their words. So some of you also may behave like this. Why? Why you are behaving like this? Your bags are throwing and you are not listening the words of your parents, watching the TV more time, and you are playing more time in the ground. You are not listening, you are not following your instructions from your parents. Why? Because these are the factors of hormones of in the adolescence age. See, have you noticed that you are growing? Certainly, when you are reaching the adolescence age, you have to notice some of the changes in your body. See, have you attaining the age of adolescence? How can you find out? See, his mustache is growing on upper lip. Mustache means nasal. Means his mustache growing on upper lip. Have you noticed that one? Did your voice change? Yes. Previously, there is no changing in your voice, but gradually when you come to that adolescence age, the female voice is different to male voice. That means boy's voice is different to the girl's voice. Boy's voice somewhat hoarse because of that Adam's apple, that we will explain in a detail. Next, are hairs growing on under armpit? Certainly it starts beginning. Next, are there pimples or acne on your face? Yes, pimples are beginning to
pimples are starts are beginning in this age because of that oilish which is accumulated in the these skin pores. Next, are you taking care of your face by applying the powder and combing your hair frequently? Yes, your at present, that means adolescence age, the boys or girls, they are more interested to combing frequently and applying the powder. Means, are you feeling shy when talking with the opposite sex? Yes, for example, boys and girls, they are feeling shy with the opposite sex while feeling shy when talking. Next, are you not interested to play with the opposite sex, which you have done in earlier? So in the previous classes, I mean that 5th class, 4th class, 3rd class, you both boys and girls, there is no differentiation in the gender. All of them, you have to mix and you have to play. But while you are reaching into adolescence, means 8th class, 8th standard onwards, you are not interested to play with the opposite sex. Next, are you showing restlessness while your parents suggest to you to do something? Yes, you are not enough to the two sessions to listening position because of you are having the restlessness. All these changes you are going to notice, so that obviously you are reaching the age of adolescence. Next video we are going to explain the remaining part. Just we have to look at a glance what are the concepts which are related to this lesson. So changes at adolescence mainly increases in height, observing the growth rate. Next, changes in our body and Adam's apple in adolescence, sweat and pimples, what should be done, reproductive phase of life in humans. Next, people and mites, child marriage, a social evil, fast and forget, and the checklist of the adolescence. Next, hormones and adolescence. Hormones and adolescence. Next one is adolescence and health, balanced diet, cleanliness. Next one is cleanliness. Next, physical exercises. Next, do you know, think and discuss. So these are the learning outcomes of this chapter. We will going to explain in a detail one by one in this chapter. See children, before coming to that, the videos watching, take the textbook in front of you and follow the textbook according to these videos. So you have to watch the videos regularly again and again for better knowledge. Thank you children. Thank you.